Hello and welcome, guys, and welcome to yet another live session. And yes, as committed to all of you, I'll be live again and again and again, and I love to do this all through the week. I can come live again and again just to introduce you to certain winners, certain achievers who have got through the three alphabets before their name, CMA. And guys, it is really well said that the victory is seen by everyone, but the pain, the effort, the struggle which is behind that victory is seldom seen by people. So today, to discuss the victories, the struggles, the obstacles, the hindrances, the achievements, everything, we have with us CMA Urvi Mehta. And yes, as you've read in the thumbnail, she is 48 years old. She has two daughters and almost of about your age. I mean, 18, 19, that's the age of their her daughters. And even at this age, she had the guts. She had the determination to do CMA. And you guys tell me that, sir, we are not able to study well. We are not able to study the theoretical subjects. We are not able to study the practical subjects as we feel lazy during the day. We are tend to sleep when we study theory subjects, etc., etc., etc. Guys, under such situation, managing household responsibilities, managing the entire family, managing expectations of the entire family, and still coming out victorious, that is CMA Urvi ma'am for you. Many congratulations, Urvi ma'am, and welcome to this live session. So yes, ma'am, this is an achievement. This is a victory. This is a milestone which you have achieved. You are actually an inspiration, pride for me. I'm fortunate enough to having been mentored you, and I have been getting this opportunity to be on touch with you on the calls, to resolve your queries and give you the guidance into subjects. But overall, ma'am, how has the experience been?
First of all, thank you very much, sir, for all your guidance and everything that you have done for me. Like all the times you have attended my calls, all the messages you have answered me. Thank you very much for that. And hello to everybody. Sir has done a lot for me. I had not imagined that I would be at this position today, which I am. I'm yet not able to tell myself that I have achieved this, because like it was a very, very unachievable thing for me before some years. Like I had left it about more than 25 years ago. I had 25 years ago, I had cleared my inter, and due to some personal reasons, I just stopped it. Then there
which
was
year,
a
ma'am? Which year?
I think 95 I left it. Oh. 95. And I had been married at that time. After that, I left it because of all the personal things and all. But there was a guilt that I left it incomplete. Then I had my two daughters. I brought them up. They are not 18, 19. My elder daughter is 23. She has done her MBBS. She's done her MBBS. And younger one is in engineering. She's in third year engineering. After that, I felt till 10th standard, I have taught them, because I take tuitions also. I teach kids. All that had been with me all the time. So after that, after finishing their responsibility of getting them doing something in the life, giving them like motivation to do this MBBS or engineering, whatever, then I thought maybe now it is the time that I can complete this. It was very difficult for me to take up also, because I felt whether I will be able to do it or not, or again I will fail into it. Yes. But still I took up that let's make an attempt to do that. So I tried it. Group 3 when I did 2019, I had done classes like here. I stay in Kandivali, Malad. So I did classes in Borivali, because till then I didn't know. I felt that I had to start from scratch. I didn't know that I can finish finals. When I take up, I thought I have to do my inter also, so I was not ready to take up. But when I went institute, I inquired. They said no, you can give finals, not a problem. So I took up class. I had to go evening classes, all household work, kids, tuitions, everything I used to manage. Then I used to study day and night. I used to study whenever I used to get time, I used to study. Like people of 20, 23, what they study, I did more than that 10 to 12 times. What revision they do, I did it more than that. Like maybe they can remember 3 to 4 times if they practice. Had to do 7 to 8 times, maybe 10 times, because I was not able to recollect the theory subjects. Also, they were finding difficult, and I don't have any practical experience. Yes, so that was a major fallback for me. I didn't have any practical knowledge. Whatever books were giving me, I had to do that. So I used to keep on asking questions to the classes which I had done. Then when I took up group, I used to keep on asking you the two subjects that I had doubt. One more subject, GST, I had done it to somebody else. And CFR, I did it on my own, the fourth subject. So I used to take all the YouTube channels and all, jahan pe se bhi jo bhi kuch milega, I used to study from that. Study from the institute books, then scanner, and everything that I got, I studied from that. I tried my level best. Still, I was not sure that I am going to clear it.
But finally.
Yeah, finally I cleared.
You have achieved 3 for your name. So, ma'am, what was the reaction of your family, of your husband, of your kids when they heard that, yes, mom is a CMA?
Yeah, they were jumping. Like before I jumped, they were jumping. That, wow, it's an inspiration. Their friends also kept on telling that your mom is a true inspiration. Yeah. What we are not able to do at this time, she has done at this age. So it is quite inspiration for everybody. Like, absolutely. I hope that becomes inspiration for all the kids who are studying at their time. I would tell them, you should study at that time only, because this is not the time to study.
So, ma'am, one question which always haunts me is that while you were doing this course, even your family members, your friends, your relatives, you know, they tell us, they tell the younger generation also that, tumse nahi ho payega, ye cheez tumhare bas ki nahi, tum kya kar rahe ho, tum to nahi kar paoge, kitne attempt ho gaye, and you might not be able to do it. Didn't they used to tell you ki what are you going to achieve with this? Why are you doing this, etc.? Didn't they used to demotivate you? How did you tackle that situation?
Yeah, some people tell that, but in my house, my daughters, my husband were always they used to always tell, no, you go ahead. If you feel that you will be able to do it, you should go ahead and you should do it. Not a problem. Like, they were not demotivating me. Never. I was only getting demotivated on myself, because one thing I don't remember, I used to get frustrated. I used to get anxiety that, no, I have taken this up at a wrong time. So I should not have done it. Otherwise, I'll be failure again. So that failure thing was really upsetting me all the time, that I'm going to fail. And third group, really, I was so much frustrated that SFM paper was...
SFM, yes.
Very bad for me. I felt that it was very bad. Maybe I was not able to judge whether I had wrote properly or not, because I was giving exam after so many years. I was not really confident about myself. So I felt that, no, I'm not going to clear. And if I don't clear, I'm not going to attempt again.
Yes.
Because repeated attempts, I won't give. I cleared all the attempts in one go. I didn't attempt again and
Right. Great. So, ma'am, what were your strategies to tackle the theoretical subjects which require a lot of learning things, learning concepts, learning sections, learning provisions? How did you tackle that? How did you learn everything in a short span of time so that you can reproduce it well?
I used to read it again and again, again and again, again and again. Still, I was not... When I gave exams also, I felt that I was forgetting many things, like whatever I had revised. Like 23, 24 years, a child remembers in 3 to 4 go. I had revised it almost 10 times. Still, in the exams, I was feeling that I'm not recollecting things very fast. But still, I wrote how much ever I could. I recollected it and I wrote it, and I could clear the attempt. Like law, it was...
Law, yes. Law is humongous.
Third group. Yeah, but I read whatever I could, whatever best I could remember. I used to remember it point-wise. so that and sections, many of them I had left. Okay, I won't write the sections. If I remember, I will write. Otherwise, I won't write wrong.
Yes, yes.
So I wrote whatever point why I had remembered, and then I used to elaborate it.
Right, right. And how was your experience giving the MCQ based online examination, especially the part which we had to type, the descriptive type questions which we
had
to type?
That was very difficult, because CFR paper, first CFR paper was there. I miscalculated it because that was the first time I was writing, typing, and I didn't know that there is going to be so much of typing, and I was not so fluent with typing. So I attempted wrong question. And that is how I was very demotivated when I wrote CFR paper, because I thought if I would have written the theory, I would have attempted the theory, it would have been better. But I didn't have time because I attempted the wrong. But in the other three papers, I attempted the theory first. I completed my writing, typing in first hour, and then I did all the practical questions.
So, ma'am, how much time would it take, an adequate time period which will be taken by a final student who would be appearing in June 21 examination? What should his time management strategy be like?
See, according to me, you should start like whenever they are doing classes or something after the December attempt, when the results come, February or something like that, because last year it was February. So February results came, I started then and then, because I was feeling that I won't be able to do it in such a short span of time. Because last year when results came March, I was feeling that I'm not going to clear my third group because of CFR, SFM paper.
SFM.
But then, but then I got the results and I cleared. Then and then I contacted you and I told you that June I will attempt only two papers, because I won't be all the four papers, because I'm not of that caliber. I don't know. I felt that. So I had started from day one. After all the household work, after tuitions and everything, whenever I used to get time, I used to keep on studying. I had lost my sleep also. As it is, I'm a less sleeper. So I was not sleeping also, but I was reading. Whenever I get time, I used to read. So for 6 months are enough for the age group of 2025. That is fine for them. They can finish it in 3 months also if they want.
Right.
But for me, it was very difficult. I got that extended time. So I could finish it off and I could give the best that I tried.
Absolutely. Yes, yes. So ma'am, what are the resources? What are the study materials which according to you are best for attempting the paper and studying?
Whatever classes you have taken up, like your notes were apt for me. I did everything from that. Then our institute module, I did that. Because for others, like GST, I had done some other video lectures. But I did module, and module was really helpful for me. Because I had done CA sir, hai na, unka maine liya tha video lectures. So that was according for the apt for the CA students. Then when I gave mock test, I felt that I have not done this. Then I went through module and I did module. So many things from module, so many things. Whichever I had not done from the sir's lectures, I did it from module. So module are apt for them. CFR, you don't understand many things from the module. So I saw video lectures. Then I asked some of my friends, can you help me with this? Because I'm not able to do it. I used to do repeatedly that. CFR, I used to do repeatedly. Even all the subjects I have done repeatedly. I've not left anything. Theory, some part I would have left, like one or two chapters I must have left.
Yes.
But from your notes, it was apt. Like if you do whatever you had given, it was more than enough to clear with good marks.
And how about CFR? Because CFR is a pain point for many students.
Yes, it was.
Study material. How did you tackle study material?
I used to read some things I did not understand, like business combination. Last part, I was not able to understand how much ever I tried from the module. I had seen lectures of Sanjay Wilkins, sir.
Yes.
YouTube lectures, jo unke free, wo the, YouTube pe. Wo somebody had told me that. So I saw that also. But I was not understand the later part. Then mock test mein something different came. Something different, which I understood again. But wo to paper mein aaya hi nahi. that did not come in the paper. I was so hopeful ki ye aayega to mujhe isme bhi marks aayega, lekin wo aaya hi nahi. But then theory and all I managed somehow ki jiska jiska maine practical mein mujhe problem tha, I was finding difficulty in practicality, I did theory for that ki agar if theory comes I will balance in that if I can't attempt practical.
Right. Ma'am, what is the source of energy, what is the source of inspiration which had actually guided you all through this path?
Inspiration, one you have to give your mind that if you want to achieve something, you have to tell your mind that no, I have to do this anyhow. Otherwise, yes. Mind is the main problem. To do something or not do something, mind always comes in between. Okay, this I won't be able to do. Yes, this I will be able to do. So you have to keep on telling your mind that yes, you have to do it. And I had a continuous guilt with me that I had left this incomplete some years back. So if I'm getting chance, why not complete it?
Correct. That is amazing. And that point of yours that mind is everything. Body also follows mind. So if you are feeling tired, then actually it's not the body, it's the mind. So if your mind is telling you that you are not tired, so as you told me that after doing all the household work, then you used to study. So you must be strong in your mind somewhere that, okay, no, even if I'm tired, I have to study and I have to take out the time for studying because
I had done mistakes some years back that I left it incomplete. So now I had to tell my mind, okay, no, I don't have to do that mistake again.
Right.
So maybe my mind became stronger than before.
Right. And do you suggest the same thing for the students who are working as well as studying? Now they find it very difficult to take out time.
Yeah, but if they are working, then also their main problem is as the age grows, the learning faculty reduces, the thinking capacity, keeping things in mind becomes really very difficult. And if you are able to do at that age, if they are able to do work, study, then why not? They can remember more. They have the caliber to remember more. So they can, they have to do it at that time only because it is the right. This is maybe late for me, but I tried it and I achieved it. I will give everybody tell that only that the right time is study when you are supposed to study.
Right. Absolutely great, ma'am. So, ma'am, last question to you. Last three tips, any three or two tips which you want to give to the students who are appearing in June 21 examination. We are already sitting on 9th of April. April, 20 days are left. May, some days are left. June, some days are left. So, what should their appropriate strategy be according to you?
Just strategy is keep on reading whatever you are losing out. Try to get thorough with it. Keep on just motivate yourself that no, I have to do it. So anyhow, that I will achieve it. And reading, though they are reading because they all know that they have to clear and they have to be, they have to get the three letters before them, their name. So they will achieve it.
Absolutely.
And one more thing I had to tell that I am into, I'm doing other activities also. Like I'm into marathon. I run 21 kilometers.
Last 21 kilometers.
So I am into half marathon. I am doing it since last 3 years.
Wow.
So super. That is another addition. Then I did my fashion designing also because earlier I felt that I won't be able to do this. That is not the right time. So I had done fashion designing also. I am into it, that also. I keep on doing things which tell me that I will be able to do this. So after that, I took up this and now I'll finish this.
Absolutely. That is great. Which means, ma'am, apart from studies, you are also involved into a lot of things. And definitely after having this conversation with you, I had received so many comments. And even I am of the same opinion that age is just a number. It's all in your mind. If you determine something in your mind, then you are going to achieve it. And no one can stop you from achieving it.
Yes. So age is not the barrier. Mind is the barrier.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for taking out time and being part of this channel, being part of this talk. It is really an inspiration and motivation to talk to you. And a lot of messages have come by during my chat, which says that, ma'am, you rock. Ma'am, we are proud of you. Ma'am, you are an all-rounder. You are a great inspiration. etc. And I cannot disagree with all these comments. This is an amazing achievement which you have done, and you've given actually me an opportunity to introduce you to all my subscribers so that they be motivated for June 21 examination. Thank you so much for taking out time for us.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for all your support and help that you have done me through this great time of mine. And thank you very much, guys. Thank you very much. Stay motivated and achieve your degree. Thank you so much.
Okay, guys. So that was Urvi ma'am for us. And yes, even when I get such requests, even when I get such information, or some person calls me and says that I want to do CMA, I want to buy your lectures, and I find that there is some spirit, there is some divine thing which is different about that particular person, that even after settling down in life, even after achieving an age, even after getting a well-settled family, someone wants to really struggle, someone wants to achieve something, not for earning money, not for making a career, but just to complete their incomplete dreams. Just to get that feeling, just to have that feeling from someone, it gives me goosebumps. So yes, Urvi ma'am's interview was nothing less than a goosebump, nothing less than an inspiration for all of us. And yes, I can read through all your chats, and people are writing, absolutely incredible, proud of you, ma'am, absolutely incredible, inspiration. Yes, guys, Urvi ma'am is really an inspiration for all of us. And it is a clear message to you. Everything is in your mind. Everything is in your mind. Body just follows mind. Wherever you want body to go, it will go wherever your mind tells it to go. So next time, if you feel sleepy, if you do not feel like studying, just remember Urvi ma'am, and just remember her words. It's all in your mind. Just channelize your mind in a way that you can achieve success in your forthcoming examination. And yes, an important message, an important notification which has been released by the Institute today. Practical training is exempt for students who are appearing in June 21 examination owing to COVID, increasing cases of COVID in the country. So yes, who are appearing in June 21 examination, practical training is not required to be completed by them. So yes, after such an inspirational talk with Urvi ma'am, I hope and pray that you guys will be back to your studies. You guys will be back to your study schedule and rock June 21 attempt and achieve good marks. And I'm talking to you. I want all of you to be on this panel, to be in front of me and discussing your inspiration story after 4 months. Till that time, all the very best and happy studying.